Hi guys, welcome to this week's plumberparts.co.uk video. Today we're going to be looking at smart water technology. This is an automatic leak detector and shutoff valve from Rehau that can tell you on your phone, wherever you are in the world, that there's a leak and automatically shut the water off. So this is what you're going to learn in this week's video. We're going to unbox and check out in depth the new Re.Guard ultrasound leak detector and automatic shutoff device from Rehau. We'll show you a step-by-step installation in the studio here, binding it with the hub and water sensor add-on. Little dribble of water, so we've had a tiny little leak, just a little tiny bit. See what happens. It's gone off. Oh my God. And demonstrate the app and how to set up this simple system before installing in a real life job for my customer Chris. You'll even have a chance to win one in the upcoming live stream. Remember, all the tools I use in this video you can buy in our Amazon store, links below. If you've got any comments or thoughts or questions about this product, having watched today's video, I'm going to be doing a live stream to answer those questions for everyone on the Plumber Parts YouTube channel. The link to that is below. It's going to be on the Thursday after this video is released at 6:30. So it's an AO Army open for everyone. Anyway, let's get on with the video and remember to hold tight. So what does this product do? You want the peace of mind, don't you, that if there's a leak somewhere in the loft or in the basement or under the floor, or there's a burst pipe in the winter, or any kind of rupture or problem that's going to cause water damage to the house, wouldn't it be great if you had a product that would automatically shut it off and also send a ping to your phone to let you know that there's been a problem? That would be wicked, wouldn't it? And that's exactly what the Rehau Smart Water Control does. So before I go any further, let's open up the box and also I'll show you the associated accessories with this beast to make all of that possible. Oh yeah, and also, check out my new t-shirt as well. Oh baby. So then, what do we get in the box? Let's have a look. These bits here I'll come to in a sec. Wow, that is some tight boxage. So, first things first, the most important bit, the instructions. Remember what I've said in the past. If you're a man, chuck them away. If you're a woman, read them and do it right the first time. I've said it so many times. Then underneath, oh, look at that beast. Really, really nicely packaged, nice and safe. So here we have our actual valve. We'll give you a closer look at this in a minute. We've got our control interface across the top. This is actually touch screen here. On the end, we've got 1-inch threaded connectors, which I'll show you how to use them in a minute to install. On the back, we've got a power lead here. And then we've just got our power supply. So here you can see, you get a really good idea as to how simple this product is. You could install this like it is right now, plug it in and turn it on, and that's it, it would be done. But you can also control these using the app, and we'll be looking at that later on in the video. Remember, if you've got any questions about what we're doing right now in this video, and you're watching it as soon as it's come out on the Saturday, you can write them below in the comments, and I'll be answering them on Thursday's live stream. If you've missed the live stream, and you're watching this after the live stream's gone out, I'll leave a link to the live stream in the description below anyway, so maybe some of your thoughts and comments would have been picked up by other viewers and you can still get some answers there. If not, anyway, I'm going to leave links to Rehau's website and you'll be able to speak to their technical team as well and ask them any questions you may have. But hopefully this video is going to cover off most of the questions that you've got. But also, we've got a couple of other products as well. Number one, and most importantly, if you want to be using the app and having that wireless thing, is having the hub. Now, this is a way for you to connect this valve wirelessly to your internet and therefore to your phone, to the rest of the world. Therefore, it's the gateway for this valve to tell you anywhere in the world what's happening and why. It's a really, really handy thing to have, and just imagine the peace of mind you get from knowing there might have been a little bit of a leak, but hey, it's already shut off and thankfully your house isn't going to get flooded. The other thing you can have as well with this is the water sensor, this little beast here. These are wicked. All they do, they've got a small set of prongs along the bottom like so, and what you do, you lie them on the floor in an area where you think, this could be prone to leaks, i.e. airing cupboards, next to the boiler, or next to your hot water cylinder, or maybe behind where all the boxwork is for some toilet plumbing, something like that. You can pop this in that spot. Then if there's any water detected by these probes, it will signal straight to this to shut off the water and prevent any further water damage. So if you get these as part of your Rehau package, then great. But also you do still have the option of just installing this on its own, plugging it in, turning it on, and it doing a great job for you anyway. So before I do an install for you at the studio, just out of shot here, because it's going to be really good for me to have remote leak detection and also a shut off at the studio itself, because I don't really want to flood my studio. Look at all the stuff I've got in here. I mean, who would want to do that? Let's have a quick look, a closer look at each one of these products in turn. So firstly, if we just remove the little end cap here, you're going to see an arrow that denotes which way the water should be coming through. So we're gonna have our cold main coming in here. It's gonna be closed or opened and sensed using the remote ultrasonic sensor. And then it's gonna go out of here, hopefully never to leak, but you never know. And that's why we fit one of these. When it comes to the actual ends, these are inch mail threads on here with a flat on the end. So we should be able to get a nice flat seal on there. We've got both at each end like that. On the back, we've got our connecting wire, and then our lead is about 1.25 meters. It's really important that we don't cut or alter the lead. One thing I'd like to say is, what if we've got a water supply coming in, not from this end, but from this end? Well, we turn this around like so. We've got two little lugs, one here and one here, and we can just press that in and then pull the lid off like so. And then this is where it gets really interesting. We'll have a closer look at this in a sec. You can twist this round and then pop that back on there like so. And there we go, that's all back together again. The bottom lights here have lots and lots of different indicators. Now, I've left a link to Rehau's website below, because there's lots of different types of fault that they can show up, like there's a leak of this sort, because it can actually sense what type of leak you have. That is cool. And if you want to find out about all those functions and all the cool things that this valve can do, there are so many, I don't think I could fit them all into this video. That's what I suggest you do. Click on the link at the end of the video, okay? So let's have a closer look inside. So first things first, we can remove this top piece here by undoing this small plug here, but just by gripping the white of that small plug. And then you'll see a small circlip just here. You pull that circlip out, we can then pull off our valve motor. And we'll come back to this in a second. Inside here, we've got a place to put our backup batteries. And to do that, we just move these two lugs just here, pop them off like so, and then you'll be able to pull the battery pack out and easily pop your batteries in. These take 4 AA batteries, and as you can see, it's indicated which way around they go. Fairly standard stuff there. You'll notice that on the bottom of the motor, we've got our four pins that actually show where it goes, that actually sight it, and then the actual actuator in here that will get moved to open and close the valve when it's being operated normally. Now, inside the valve body, this is where we've got the really cool new technology. What we're doing is we're using ultrasound here to measure the flow of water through the valve. Now, the difference between this leak detecting valve and other types is that most other types use a paddle or an impeller to actually move when the water's going over the top of it because there's a leak. Now, the problem with that is obvious, isn't it? It's a moving part. And moving parts can always fail. So that's why this is so much better, and also miles more accurate. When it comes to the ultrasound side of things, I don't have the intelligence to be able to tell you exactly how that works, but it does work. One thing I'd like to say as well is, look, we've got everything thought about here. We've got a small Allen key here that if we actually have to manually work this valve to open or close it, we can pull it out of its housing, pop it on here like so. So that's in the closed position right now. And that's in the open position right now. And we can just pop it back in there like that. Because our water is actually running this way on this installation, what I'm going to do is now pop this back together, ready for that type of installation. Then the valve head. Then our circlip. And now that's ready to be installed on our pipework. When it comes to the Rehub, this is what you're going to be looking at. Really, really simple product. We have our Ethernet cable in at the back here. We've also got a USB cable here and our power lead here. Very important to know that this back slides off, and this will only allow you to start pairing and doing stuff like that if the back is off. Now, you don't need to use the back plate to fix this to a wall. You can just lay it on top of a desk or on top of a unit, and that will work absolutely fine. But that's the physical features of the back of the Rehau hub. So nice and simple to use as well. So a good addition to this whole setup is this lovely little Rehau water sensor here. What it has, it's got three probes on the bottom, and then you'll lay that on a low point or a place that you think might be prone to flooding. So maybe a basement or an airing cupboard or near your boiler or under the kitchen sink. And that will be able to talk to the hub and say, oh, I've noticed some water. Then it can communicate with our Re.Guard here and turn the water off. How cool is that? So really, really simple little product. It's got a little battery in there already that when we undo the plate at the bottom, you just pull out the tag and then follow the instructions for getting it bonded up. And I'll show you how to do that in a minute. So these are brilliant for domestic properties and also commercial properties, giving you peace of mind. Really good if you're a landlord and you're worried that, you know, there might be a leak and your tenant doesn't know about it, but also just brilliant for peace of mind in the home as well. So why don't we get one of these installed now in at the studio? You can watch the process of me fitting it and then using the app to get it all fully set up and working. And then after that, I'll do another install actually out on site at a lovely detached property out in the countryside. So let's do it, guys. Let's go. Right then, so what I'm going to be doing is I'm installing the rear guard on this little section of pipe here. Now, the water main is just over there out of shot. It doesn't serve any other outlets at all. It just comes this way. But the reason I'm putting it here is to demonstrate to you that if you've got a pressure reducing valve, then put it on after the pressure reducing valve. That's what you should be thinking of doing. Another thing you should do, once you've got into where you're thinking of installing it, make sure that number one, you can reach a power outlet. We've got a nice power outlet just there. Make sure as well that number two, you've got a good internet connection where you are. It's quite easy to do that just by going onto your phone and having a look at the strength of the signal on there. If you've got 3 bars on your little Wi-Fi jobby, that means that we're ready to roll. So first up, let's get the beast out. Instructions, but also knee pad. Right, so we've got the one that I was just showing you a minute ago. I've already got my arrows pointing the right way. So it's just a matter now of using a bit of plumbing knowledge to get these reduced down from inch male to 15 millimeter soldered. That's what we're gonna do. Right, so number one, the connectors that we can use and the ways that you can seal up the thread for those connectors. Now, for this job here, I'm gonna show you a method that uses a rubber O-ring that sits inside here and makes a watertight seal on the flat there. We've then got a compression here. That's gonna go into a reducer that reduces down to 15 millimeter, and off we go, we're all good again. But there is another way that we can do that, and I'm gonna show you that on another job when we install this in a domestic property in a few minutes time in this video. But for now, I wanna show you this way. So the great way about doing like this is that we can get it nice and tight all the way up, and you don't really need to over-tighten it that much. It's quite easy to get it on because rubber tends to not need to be over-tightened. You can just get it on a nice flat face. You probably just nip it up with your hands and then just give it a quick nip up, making sure that you grab the brass body here and not the plastic, because if you do that, you could damage the plastic. So we just wanna give that a nip up like that. That's now watertight, and I can even see the seal inside. Same again, just feed the seal down. Now you can also do this with a fibre washer and a little bit of jointing compound. That will do the job just as well. It's just with fibre washers, you tend to find they do up a lot harder. Once they get to their seal point, there's no give like what you get in a rubber washer, and it will just go real hard, and you know, you're pretty much there. That's the noise they make, believe me. We've got that on there. I mean, I'm just showing you how quick it is to install one of these. Sometimes you're gonna need a bit of soldering knowledge, but you know, you can get these to go down to 15 mil. I just couldn't get any at the suppliers. So it's fairly easy to do. So once you've got that like that, I'm gonna just undo these and we'll get this installed. So every time you're working with olives, I say this so often on all my videos, just make sure you put a bit of jointing compound on the olive. Jointing compound's really, really easy to get. It's in our Amazon store as well. Just buy it, and then what you do, you rub it on the olive, rub it on the fitting. Okay, you're gonna get a little bit on your jeans, because that's where you clean your fingers. But the thing is it allows the olive to slip. It allows the compression fitting behind it to slip, which means now when we do this up, we can get a nice tightened up seal that doesn't squeak. Squeak means you could get a leak. That's what I always say. It's just really important to make sure that you get a nice dollop on the olive and everything, and it just makes everything go up so much easier. So hopefully you get it so it's looking a bit like that. Lovely. And we're gonna pop that in our fitting here. Now, I know what some of you are gonna say. You say, oh my God, I can't believe he is about to solder up, knowing that he's got a rubber fitting in there. These will not get hot enough at this area to melt that rubber, believe me, okay? And also, I could show you a tiny little trick today, just a couple of extra tips if you are worried about that sort of thing. So I'm just gonna do these up now. Let's get these up nice and tight. Oh man, I yet to use my mouth glaze right there. Oh my God. So what we might do is just make a little set, because we want to keep the width here. So what we're going to do is we're going to pop a little set on. So whilst I'm doing this, you might as well pop over to the App Store and search for Rehau Re.Guard and download the Re.Guard app. Once you've opened that, you'll need to fill in all of your details, usual sort of stuff, name, surname, address, password and email. Check your email address to make sure that you've got your verification email. Once you've clicked on that, you'll be able to enter the app itself. So I'm going to show you my nifty little soldering trick in a minute. If you want to protect a joint that you think might have a rubber seal in it or something like that, and you need to do a heat sink. As you can see, I've put two small sets on this just to set out and also up our rehab so it fits where it wants to go. And just look at that. Can you believe it? My brand new heat mat caught fire. I think I'm going to be doing an update on the heat mat pretty soon.
How is that on fire? I mean, that is ridiculous. That's supposed to be a heat mat. So if you want to protect something, you just pop some water on there and you get the bit you want to protect, which is that there. And you wrap that around it like that. And that will act as a heat sink while we do this solder.
So I guess you could say we're using water's higher conductivity to conduct heat away and also flash it off into steam away from the product and also the fitting that we're trying to protect. This is an old school way of doing things. I've never known it fail. It works every time. Just look how neat this install's coming along.
Right, so the water's back on. We can actually hear water trickling back down this soil pipe at the moment and passing through this. I just want to show you the function of switching this off manually. You just pull this out, take that off and just lay it there if you want. This is only in emergency situations. There we go, it's off. And back on again. So there we go, that's how that works. So then guys, that's all done. Before I plug it in, we're just gonna go and get the hub sorted out. Really easy to do. So I'm just gonna pop to the studio router and get that done now. Right then, so my router is up there. I have to have it high up because I wanted to get a really good signal over to the rest of the studio, which is all over there behind you. What we're gonna do is we just take the back plate off our rehab, just like so. And then I'm gonna find a nice suitable place to hang this. So then it gets a nice signal straight through to where the rear guard valve is. Inside the box for this, we've got our instructions, but also we've got a set of screws that you can use to install it. We've got our quick guide, which we're gonna pop over there and read in a minute. We've got our Ethernet cable, which we're gonna be using to plug into the back of our router up there and then into the back of the hub. And also we've got our small power lead as well. There are screws and plugs supplied with the Rehub, but because I'm going into wood here, I'm just gonna use some standard wood screws, pop up underneath the Ethernet cable. Now you can plug the Ethernet cable into the back of the Rehub, plug the power cable in as well, but do not latch it onto the back plate just yet. Right, so now we've got it to this stage, just take 5 minutes. These take about 5 minutes to boot up. So clear up what you've been doing, bits and bobs like that. Pop a 5 minute timer on your watch or whatever. Just make sure you give it a little while before you come back to it. After about 5 minutes, the Rehub will indicate that we're ready to move on to the next stage with these white pulsating indicator lights. You're gonna open up the Rehub app that I spoke to you about earlier on, and we're gonna get to step one. It says here, connect the Rehub to your router using the included network cable. We've already done that, so it's plugged in there, and it's plugged into the back of my router on one of the four LAN outputs that I've got. Remove the back cover of the Rehub by sliding it downwards. We've done that already. Now connect the Rehub to the mains with the power supply unit. Yes, we've done that. Don't you love the fact that all the instructions are here? You don't have to go through a book loads, but there is a book if you want to. Now you'll be prompted to connect the Re.Guard to the mains. Now you should be within 2 meters of the Rehub, which sometimes means you want to do this before you physically install the Re.Guard. But I found in testing and also when we install this in the house, which is coming up in a few minutes, that I could do this stage with 10 to 15 meters difference and also through walls. Anyway, you power up the Re.Guard and then just wait a few minutes before popping back to the hub and using your phone camera to scan the QR code on the back. At this point, the hub will test the connection, register your Rehub, and then guide you through the brief configuration process. Go back to the Re.Guard and press the Wi-Fi button for about 3 seconds until it flashes white. The Rehub and the Re.Guard will establish a connection automatically, after which we have the option to add a water sensor. Unscrew the back of the sensor and remove the battery tab, then press down the button until the LED light flashes blue. Press next on the app. The Rehub and water sensor will automatically make a connection now. You can now rename the water sensor for where you're gonna put it. I'm gonna shove this under the studio kitchenette sink. This is a really handy feature because you can have up to 5 sensors on one Rehub. So I am gonna fit this in here. Look, I've got the app now. Do you want me to turn the water off? Just click on this. Oh yeah, and there's the water off. Turn it on again. Oh, look at that. How cool is that? It's telling us the pressure, we've got the temperature, we've got the amount of litres that we've put through, we've got the flow, all those things. Now, we've got our notifications as well. It's saying everything is fine at the moment. Well, what we're going to do, we're just going to sit this in some water and see how quickly we get something through to say, oh, there's a leak, we got a problem. So you see, it's sat there right now, no trouble whatsoever. Okay, let's pop a little dribble of water on here. Little dribble of water. So we've had a tiny little leak, just a little tiny bit. See what happens. It's gone off. Oh my God. If we come back here, the valve knows that there's been a problem, and also we're alerted on our app that we've had a leak. Also, the Rehau knows that this is quite a bad leak because we've got it on there. If we've got a very small dripping leak and it shuts the water off, this one here will be lit up red. Now, we could try and reset this now by pressing this down, but it's not going to happen, and it's not going to let us open up the valve either. What we have to do is fix the leak, dry out the sensor, and only then will it allow us to turn the water on. You just wait there. I come back to my phone. It says we've got a leak. So the app knows that the water is off. I'll dry this out now, just, you know, as if we're fixing that leak that we've had. Hopefully that's nice and dry now. Just pop that on there. There we go. Now that's reset. And now I press this button and the water supply is re-established once we've fixed the leak. You can have up to 5 of these on one system, but the water sensor is really a secondary way for the Rehau Re.Guard to know that there's a leak. The main way for it to know it's a leak is the ultrasound technology that they've got in here that monitors water usage. There's a couple of wicked things. You can say to it, you're going on holiday, so you can say, I'm now absent and I'm away. And it will know then that any water that goes through it or within certain parameters that you can set within the app, any water like that can go through it, that goes through it, it's going to shut off. Or you could say, right, I'm just going to go away. I'm turning the water off. Just press that button, the water's off. Think how cool that is for, you know, an elderly occupant or someone who doesn't really know about plumbing, how to turn valves on and off, that sort of thing. It's really, really handy to know. It's open again now, just so you know. There's some other cool functions on it though. Say you're going away on holiday and you want someone to, I don't know, water the plants or feed the cat and the dog. You can set parameters up to say, let 20 litres or 30 or 40 litres through a day or however many litres you want before it shuts off. There is a preset setting that you can just have just by installing this that you won't even need the hub or anything like that. It will just run on its own in that way. So now let's venture out into the countryside and fit one of these lovely Re.Guards on a real life job. So we're now on site at this domestic property where we're going to be installing the Rehau Re.Guard on this water main coming in here. So this house has 2 bathrooms, 1 ensuite, a kitchen and also a utility room. So we've got a really good domestic property situation to show you here. This will show you how easy it is to install one of these and also the peace of mind that it's going to give my customer. One thing I would recommend before you figure out where you're going to site something is to turn up to site and make sure that you get a good Wi-Fi signal in the place where you're going to install it. That's what I've done here already. We've got really, really good Wi-Fi, so I'm going to be able to install the Re.Guard in here. We're also going to put a leak monitor just down here on this low point. Then I'll get it all connected up onto the app, show the customer how it works, and leave them with the peace of mind that when they go on holiday eventually, they don't have to worry about loads of water flooding and ruining their home. So then the first thing we're going to do is turn the water off. Always a bit of a dodgy moment, turning the water off on any stock cock, especially one at this house where I'm fairly sure they didn't even know it was there, but it did seem to shut off okay, and that's lucky because they didn't seem to know where their other stock cock was, and in that time they'd had a whole gravel drive put in, and you know what that means. Once shut, I open the drain off out into this little bowl and remove the electrical earth bonding that I'll be putting back on later. Oh my God, that is a dirty old bit of bonding. A good idea is to now plan your install, plan where you're going to put this. We have got a little bit of a, I'd call it a higgledy-piggledy, a little bit of plumbing in here, but we're going to have to make the best out of this that we can. We can still really end up with a nice, neat install. I just think what we're going to do is, it's always a good idea just to get out the product. Oh, another knee pad, if I want. I want to think about a couple of things. How far away is our nearest electrical point? So a good idea is, it's out of shot at the moment, but there's a plug socket just up there. If I just pull this apart now, and make sure this is going to reach that plug socket. And I know it's easier going to reach because I'm going to be putting this somewhere here. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this here and we're going to go up and in and then up into our bit there. And then that keeps that nicely behind everything. We'll have to find a way of getting over this bit of pipework here, but that's kind of part of life. Need to make sure when we take it off, we can get this bit out. And look, there we go. We can do that nice and easily. So that's kind of good as well. Okay, so that's roughly where we're going to put it. Oh yeah, handy little tip for you as well. Guys, I've added this little hand pump to the Amazon store. It's so handy. I know I've got the drill pump as well, but I'm definitely going to do a review on this for the tools I love on a midweek video sometime soon. I'm pretty sure that valve is not holding. And I don't think they have a clue where their water main is here, but there we go. It's going to make this an interesting job. So look, we want to use the old nut when we're doing any work, because that's just going to go on nice. That's why. I'll pop a new olive in there as well. Now, the thing about that, when we do this sort of work, it's always a good idea now. Just to, number one, make sure that your olive seats nicely, which it does. But also, once we've got all this in and done, we make sure that we joint and compound everything nicely as well. That'll make a big difference when it comes to tightening up at the end of the job and making sure that everything's okay. Right, so we've got our first bit in here. We've already popped a little bit of joint and compound on that. So that should be okay.
Just so you know, on this job, I plugged in the Rehau and the Rehub and got them binded together and followed the steps I did earlier on in the studio before I physically installed the Re.Guard onto the pipework. This is the official method for doing this, and I actually found it a lot easier.
Now, earlier on, remember what I said, you can use a rubber seal in here or a fiber washer, or you can use Loctite like I am on this job. Loctite's great stuff because it gives you a good watertight seal, but it also really binds up the thread on there as well, making sure that if the Rehau or this joint is knocked anytime in the future, it won't come loose and it won't leak.
Remember to always read the instructions on how to use Loctite, because you don't use it like PTFE. So while I do this, I just want to tell you about another feature of the Re.Guard, and it might answer a few questions that you have about how it works to detect drip leaks, or as it calls them, micro leaks. At set intervals, the Re.Guard will briefly close the water supply and monitor the system pressure in order to see whether there's a very small leak further down the line. For example, a dripping tap or a system that keeps running or a leaking thread connection. The factory default setting for this is every day at 3 a.m. So pretty much the time when no one's going to be using any water. And you can change when it does this test within the app. If any appliance is operated during the test, the check is aborted and the water supply reinstated. There might be a delay of a few seconds before the water starts flowing again.
So now that's back on. Right, so we're all done when it comes to the actual physical installation of this. You've seen how easy it was to do. Just a little bit of pipework on this one, just to get it so it fits in and everything.
So on this one, I'm popping in some backup AA batteries just in there. Also at the same time, I'm changing over the direction of the top cover so it's the right way around. After I've done that, I'll just plug it back in and it will automatically rebind with the hub that I bound it to earlier on before installation.
I've just been given a Belgian bun. I like working here. Right then, guys, so all connected up on the app as well. I've also added this lovely little water sensor as well, and I'm going to pop that just down here. I think it's dried out enough now from the earlier work that we did. And then that will tell the app and also this valve to shut should there be any water on these little sensor electrodes here. So just out of the way, and that is the lowest point in this room. You can see all the pipework that we've got in here. What a great place to put it to make sure that you've got peace of mind for the customer, just in case you get a leak on something like the vented side, because there's quite a lot of vented pipework in here.
Also, I think you'd be interested to know as well that the Z-Wave hub is just up there. Brilliant, isn't it? And that little airing cupboard is just the other side of that wall. So a perfect little install to get all of this up to date and running properly.
So there you go, you saw how easy that was. Another easy install. Now there's going to be a chance for you to win one of these, but it's going to be on the live stream that I do on the Thursday after this video is released. Remember, if you are watching this years after this has been released, you're not going to be able to enter that competition. On Thursday, I'll answer any of the comments that you leave below this video and we'll have a chat together. It will be open to everyone on the Plumber Parts channel. You'll be able to come along, see if your comment gets addressed in that live video. You'll also be able to have a chat with me directly about the product as well, and then you'll get a chance to win one too. So I'll see you on Thursday evening. That will be there for everybody to watch. I hope you've enjoyed today's video, guys. I hope you come back for more. Remember to hit the subscribe button, hit the like, and comment below because I'll be talking about your comments on Thursday. And if you're watching this video in years time, I'll leave the link as well to that live video so you can see that perhaps some of your comments or some of your thoughts might have been addressed by someone else and asked, and then I might have addressed them in that video as well. So thanks ever so much for watching, everybody, and I'll see you in the next Plumber Parts video. Remember, there's one thing you gotta do, that's hold tight. See you soon. You gotta leave it. A tiny leaky, but don't worry, baby, 'cause Rehauer's got your back.
Yeah. I always lay in bed at night and think about potential leaks under my sink. And then my poop come up with a bit of a car. We can let that I fit a regard.
He said it off the rim. Get a good night's sleep with my cat.
Thank you.
Thank you
for the
Re.Guard.
Thanks ever so much for watching this week, guys. Make sure you hit the links on the end card. Make sure you check out Rehau's website and also get involved in the Q&A session that's going to be happening live to everyone on this YouTube channel next Thursday at 6:30 p.m. Get involved, guys. The links for that are below. I'll see you then. And remember to hold tight. See you soon.